One of the new and exciting features we've added to trakax Pro is the ability to insert text into your video and photo slideshow mixes. In this video, I'll give a basic introduction into text credits. I will cover more advanced features in part 2. So let's show you how to insert text into your mix. I'm going to start with a blank mixing window, and I'll right-click in the mixing screen and select Insert and choose Video Credits. The Video Credits dialog box will appear. So let's enter some text. Here I'll type in Seville win the UEFA Cup. As I type in the text, you can see how the text will be displayed in the video output screen. Currently, the text is aligned to center. However, you can change this default by either clicking the Align Left or the Align Right buttons. I can also move the text to any area within this text placement window, using the text margin sliders. These margin sliders allow me to place my text with precision within the text frame. Simply left click and hold on the sliders to move your text to any location. Again, I can use the video output screen to see exactly how my text will be displayed. I can right click on each slider to return them to their default state. Something I'd like to draw your attention to is the target frame size. If you're starting your text and you have a rough idea of the type of video mix you want to create, be it for YouTube, iPad, PSP, etc., simply select your target frame size from the drop-down menu. Here I'll select YouTube HQ from the drop-down menu. You can also select the target frame size for your mix using the target frame size menu in the mixing screen. The video output screen will now display your text exactly how it will be exported. If, however, you've created a mix with text with a specific frame size in the mixing window and then wish to export your mix to another frame size or device setting, trakAxPC will attempt to keep the text in the same position and dimensions within the video output screen. However, we would recommend that you check that the target frame size you select will look acceptable in the video output screen. To learn more about target frame size, please see the mixing window tutorial part 2. You will notice the text I've created has become a segment, which can be moved and adjusted in length, giving you full control over where the text is placed. If I close the video dialog box, I can always access it quickly by clicking on the text properties icon on the segment. Okay, now that I'm back in the video credits dialog box, I would like to make some changes to my text. Firstly, I would like to change the font of my text. To do this, simply highlight the text using the mouse or by right-clicking and choose Select All. In the Font Family box and using the scroll wheel on my mouse, I can browse through and select my desired font. I can also grab the scroll bar to move down the menu quickly. I also want to increase the size of my text. I can click on the size box and select my font size. I can also make my text bold, italic, and underlined. If I want to change the color of my text, again I make sure the text is highlighted and I can click on the text color box and select one from the drop-down menu. If there is a colour that is not on the drop-down menu, I can create one using the More Colours option. I can create the colour and then select Add to Custom Colours and select OK. When I'm happy with these changes, I'll now introduce a piece of video. If I drop the video underneath the text segment, the text will play on top of the video. This is because when a text channel is created, it is defaulted to always on top, and the transparent background is defaulted to on. If you do not want the text to be transparent over the video, click on either the always on top icon in the text track name to turn off this option for the whole channel, or else click on the segment properties icon and click on the always on top icon to disable this option for this individual segment. In the video credits dialog box, there is also the transparent background button, which is defaulted to on. By using the play bar, I can see the text overlays the video. When turned off, this button allows you to change the background color of the text segment. Again, I can change this color by selecting from the default color list or the more colors option in the background color box. This is very helpful when creating start and end credits. In part 2 of the text credits tutorial, we will show you some more advanced features like scrolling text, fades, effects, and more.